challenging and rewarding, especially at a small school. Dom Vitticore caretakes a successful football program at Red Jacket in Shortsville. Micah Dean with more on the Indians' longtime coach in part one of his series, Classic Coaches.
Red Jackets' Dom Vitticore was meant to be a coach. After all, athletics is part of a family tradition. His father was a baseball umpire and football referee. Dom has built a winning football tradition at Red Jacket High School. He's taken the Indians to the Section 5 championship game 7 times, winning the title twice, including last year's Class D crown. And Vitticore is still going strong after 26 years at the helm.
When times are tough, I try to reach back into my philosophy that got me into this, which 26, 27, 28 years ago, coming out of college, I wanted to work with kids. I wanted to try to make a difference, and it seems like I do. You never really know, I guess, but it seems like I do. So I'm having fun with the kids. They're great to be around. And I must admit, I've had a great relationship with the kids here, the coaches here, the parents here, and our school and community. It's been really wonderful. It's been a great ride.
Slide in. Get inside first, then break your pattern. You know what I mean?
He's 33 drives.
Get inside so we can't crack.
It's not easy keeping a small school football program on top because the number of players available changes from year to year. But for some reason, Dom has kept the winning tradition alive here at Red Jacket.
No, those two guys were good. You did good. Yeah.
Vitticore claims to be a players coach and says the players will back that up. And they do.
Don't fall in the manhole.
He's just like us. He's like one of the guys. He knows what we're going through. He's been in the league for 20 some years. He knows exactly what it's like for us. So it's like friend to friend basis instead of like a master to like understudy relationship.
Go! Chuck! Hut! Yeah, we got some hitting in. Very good. Get it together.
They also say Vitticore is patient and fair. He can take an individual with marginal talent and turn him into a good football player.
I wasn't very good. I played third or fourth string when I started, and I've moved up, but I've definitely gotten help from the coaches.
Yeah, what's he done to bring you along, do you think?
I think he's shown me quite a bit on what I've done wrong, taught me what I'm supposed to be doing, where I'm supposed to be going at times, tried to show me exactly what I'm doing wrong and why I'm doing it wrong.
Following last year's Section 5 championship, Dom thought it might be the right time to bow out. But the players talked him into returning for one more year, and now it doesn't appear Dom is ready to hang it up just yet.
It's year to year, and it's still going to be year to year. Kids, somebody asked me today, said, are you going to come back next year? And I said, I don't know. I'll talk to you about that later on. If I'm happy at the end and want to go again, I'll just keep going until I don't want to go anymore. And I think the kids will accept that one way or another.
You're happy now, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Do you see that changing, you know,
the next couple of months? No. My guess would be I'll come back and coach in 2000.
Where he will continue to be one of Section 5's classic coaches. Micah Dean, R Sports.
In part two of Classic Coaches on Tuesday, Mike visits Linda.
Well, I do think it's fair to raise the expectations, but I do have enough respect for the game to...
you ready?
Hey, think you could tell us what to do? You think you could tell us what to wear? You think that you're better? Well, you better get ready. Bow to the masters. Break it down! You can tell me what to do. You know who you're talking to. Well, you better get used to the way the war bounces. I see what you got and measures in ounces. But that's a break, boy. Yeah, that's a break, little man. Break it down. You're a big man. We'll treat you like you're a little man. Don't tell me what it's like to be half a man. It must break your heart to see what I am. One, that's a break, boy. Yeah, that's a break, little man. Break it down. You can tell me what to do. You know who you're talking to. Just not wanna leave to be someone else. Leave like a book on a shelf back. You can be boy. Yeah, that you can be little man.
what a great effort there. That is just a beautiful thing. We'll be seeing her someday, probably on Broadway. Clyde Savannah student, and we thank her for that, and we are ready to go. We expect the same type of great performance we just heard from these guys. And for the seniors who lose tonight, it's their last game. Sit back, relax, and enjoy it on the track. And here is the kick. And that's got to be one of the longest for Red Jacket all year long. And up the middle, and then doink. Oh, that was a shot. And Clyde Savannah will start it off on offense. First down from the 37-yard line. The quarterback is Brent Carnevale. He'll hand it off inside. Big yardage. Arnitz, the big fullback, running like Allstott right there. And that is not a good thing if you're on the Red Jacket side of the ball. The first play of the game, they run the fullback, and he gets about 16 or 13 yards, actually, at the 50-yard line. They love to throw the ball. They'll mix it up. They go to Kyle Grantling, and this time Mike Henry says, no soup for you. You can see that the scoreboard is actually facing into the sun, so they may want to change that board up here and put it in a different spot, because very difficult with the sun shining on it. But the only thing they did wrong up here, and Red Jacket circling the wagons. And now Carnevale is going to come over, as they do on almost every play, and get it. You know, that would wear you down, I think, as a quarterback. You got to come over there about 50 times a game and run back. Seems like teams could get a little bit of a messenger system or hand signals or something. But it's worked for Clyde Savannah all these years. From the 49, back to pass. Carnevale's got a man, got a catch, got a first down. The freshman, the fabulous freshman, Tom Farron. Great hands, and he could really run some patterns. And now another big hole for Clyde Savannah, and Red Jacket is going to have to make some adjustments, because if they don't, they're in for a long afternoon of football. Now Carnevale going to throw, got a man. It's Kyle Rattray, an unsung hero, and he catches and moves and goes. And what a first opening drive here for the Golden Eagles. Now the deep pitch to Grantling, who's got great speed, and then he just pushes one of his blockers out of the way, and it continues to be Clyde Savannah on the move. Grantling, that's where you like to see him if you're a Clyde Savannah fan, because you can see it's not how fast you get to the hole, it's how fast you go through it, and that was a prime example right there. Kyle Grantling, one of the top backs in the section. He's a little guy, probably about 5'6", 5'7", but man, he can make stuff happen. We've seen some sensational small backs this year. Anthony Palizzi from Hornell, who they list at 5'7", and no way. He's like 5'5", tops, maybe. Unbelievable, this kid. And then Kyle Grantling, and we can keep going on and on. And both these teams have great skill players. That's why they're the top teams. It's fourth down and about one, because they have, for D schools, usually you might get a couple of kids that are real exceptional skill players. These teams have four, five, six of them that they can really go to. And now the handoff, and no soup for you. The Red Jacket defense, let's take another look. Let's take another look at this effort right here. You're going to see that this time Red Jacket gets great initial surge. And they are just stuffing him up. Excellent play, and everybody comes in to help, and forget about it. We are going. The other way. So Red Jacket now with the ball. They love to run it. And one of the guys they'll go to is the big horsey, Joe Englehart. Their main back, the scat back, The elusive guy is Sam Arook, and the name is Arook. It's not Eric, or Arook, or Aruki, or whatever they call him. I never hear anybody get it right, but we're going to get it right because, well, that's what we are at Sports Track. We're going to get everything right for you because these kids deserve it. They're putting in a great effort. And Zeno gets in to make the play for Clyde. But Arook is a guy who will really leave you grabbing for air if you don't make a solid tackle. So now Red Jacket will do something they don't like to. That's throw the football. Here's Marino throwing. Picked off by Omar Rouse. Touchdown, Clyde Savannah. But wait a minute. There's a flag down. And that may be clipping, holding. Let's see what we get on the run back. Clipping against the purple and gold. They aren't too happy about it, but they're going to get the ball anyway, and that was a huge play. Clyde Savannah fans not very happy about that one. Now here is Carnevale. He's rushed, he's sacked. Look for the clip, and must have happened out of camera view there. Dom Vitticore, who played at Clyde Savannah, his brother coached there, won all those sectional championships, and has really been snake bit by this team. They lost earlier in the year, Red Jacket, 21-3 to Clyde Savannah. Carnevale rushed, look out. Little Flutie flakes right here. He rolls, he's got a man. It is Grantling, and he says, goodbye, my friend. Kyle Grantling, after some Houdini stuff by Carnevale, touchdown, Golden Eagles. This is why Clyde Savannah is so dangerous on the turf. Right here, you're going to see Grantling. I don't know how Red Jacket could let him get that open. And then right here, he says, whoop, and leaves him in the dust. You've got to put a spy around Kyle Grantling, somebody to know where he is at all times, because if not, that's how they'll hurt you. They played together for so long, and now they'll go after a deuce, and Carnevale says, oh, no, not again. Same play, and he will get in, but we're going to get a penalty flag. Let's see if we're going to pick up the penalty. We should right here. Casper says, yeah. We've got it right where they threw the flag, and yeah, definitely. That is a good call. I mean, that's just a plain old block in the back, and that freed him up to get in. So now the Golden Eagles are just going to let it fly and forget it. So that could come back to be a big play in the game. Who let the dog?